are several of us in the library that do a lot of different sample materials, and that doesn't even count in our databases and other resources that we get through the state library. So there's a lot out there and a lot to consider.
Thank you, Rachel. That was really good.
So I do have a question, Rachel. Thank you for sharing with us your process. I'm wondering, so one of the books that caught my attention in the invoices this month was called A Fascination Classroom. I'm sure that you're familiar with the manga book. And I looked it up online, and I was quite taken back by the images in the book. And I went to search in our library, and it shows that we have 11 of the first book. So my first question is, like, having 11 of one book, is that just based on popularity, or?
In the library catalog, there are actually 11 of the first book. Sometimes it's longer, and you can see from the way to catalog it. So they make it so they can click the first book and then scroll down and see that in the series there are 11 that we have, you know, 1 through 11.
A lot of times mangas are cataloged like a serial, and so it's almost like a magazine. So you just catalog the magazine once, like Time Magazine, and then as you receive issues, you add the issues in, but it's not a completely separate mark record.
Especially for stories that have 100, 200 volumes, that's the video that
Thank you. I know it's brand new to get the graphic novels. But my other question is, as a parent in our community, if I went around and I showed that book to people, I believe that it would raise alarms. I'm wondering where in the ordering process we can begin to implement if citizens are feeling alarmed about this, how that can be communicated. To me, I don't feel like it has anything to do with diversity or anything, but having kids pull guns on their teacher in a book, and I looked through that book and read a sample online, and the crazy part about manga books that I've observed is that there's actually quite little literature within them and more visual pictures. And so I'm wondering, what is that message that our library is trying to send? Is it because it's popular, because it's modern, that we're putting that in front of our kids, that that's what they're going to get?
So we have a request for reconsideration form that any citizen is able to fill out if they feel that a book should not be in the library. And as far as ordering books, manga is very popular right now. So we order manga for the publisher recommended age group, and
without
it gets checked
any
out.
Any question? That's what I'm kind of wondering. I understand there's a reconsideration form. I filled them out personally myself. I think the point I'm trying to make is it's already in our library. There's no in-between of accountability there.
The publisher. They publish it for a specific age group. It's written for a specific age group. And of course, not all parents are going to agree that that is going to be appropriate for their child of that specific age group. I mean, that's just how things go. I mean, no parent agrees on every form of media or everything that's within the media. And so that is up to the parents to decide if they feel that that book is appropriate for their child or not. But to not make it available altogether is an infringement on the public's First Amendment rights.
Yeah, I just struggle with that because ultimately it's our taxpayer dollars that are helping support that book get on the shelf. Like, to me, I am a homeschool mom. I realize that literature is expensive, and I pick and choose so carefully what I tend to spend my personal money on. And it's really crazy to me what I've gathered thus far is that there, it's kind of just like I'm handing you a checkbook and you're just doing what you want. And there's like, to me, if anything, it's like, who oversees, who's the top? And that's why I think I've brought attention to us as the board being the overseers of that and trying to figure out, it does a policy need to be made? You know, it's interesting to me that you have this selection policy. I've looked it over and I've read through it. And there is things about reputable authors. And I still continue to come across, as I go over these invoices, first-time authors. The book is published 3 weeks ago, and it's already ordered. And so it's just really hard for me that we're just trusting publishers, or we're just trusting the library journal with our children's minds. I just struggle with that.
So
I think our kids deserve more. They deserve for us to look deeper at what we're putting in front of them. I think of it like, what do I feed my family? Right? Because
but
what I put in is what's going to come out. And
if someone was telling you that you shouldn't feed your family a specific thing, how would you take that? And if someone was saying, hey, we need to make a policy to make it impossible for you to feed your family this specific thing because I don't believe that it is nutritional for your family and I don't believe that it's going to do them good, then that's not, oops, that's not okay. And so it's the very same thing. So we are offering books out there, and the parent can decide, hey, I don't think that this book is good for my kid. They're not allowed to read it. Fine. We're not making kids read anything or look at anything. Essentially, it's having it out there because it's being published. We leave it out there because we've seen School Library Journal. It's on bestsellers lists. It's been really well reviewed, whether or not you agree with it, or that it maybe you think it should be very well reviewed, that's not necessarily relevant. It's not even relevant if librarians think that or disagree with it. What's relevant is that we have the information out there as a freedom for people to be able to check out and decide on their own. And then if it isn't getting checked out, that is when the reading process comes in, and so then we weed out the books that are not getting checked out.
So I don't think I'm trying to make it impossible, but to order 140 manga books in 1 month, to me, is an excess.
Okay, but that's not an excess to me. I actually feel like that's a little low. Considering how popular manga is and how often it gets checked out, or even when I worked in the middle school, how popular manga was and how often it got checked out, given that we had that grant money and that we could have provided that information for those kids or those books for those kids. Reading is reading in a lot of ways, and there have been a lot of kids that hate reading until they discover manga, and then it actually gets them into reading. And so I've seen the benefits of it, and I honestly think that we should have purchased more manga, honestly. I was surprised when that was all that we purchased with that grant, because like I said, that's a very small percentage of what the grant was.
Yeah, Danny, I mean, I don't mean to strike a chord with you personally, and I think that I have, and I apologize if I've come across in any way that is personal. I think what my hope is for our community is that, yes, manga is popular, and that's great, and we obviously are funneling money into that, but there is also part of our community that is feeling a different way. And nobody's saying making it impossible, but to me, I feel as though from what I've seen in the invoices and the ordering is that it's not down. So you say we need more manga, and then you have patrons who are requesting things, and I think it's so interesting when you pull up the website for a request. It's very clear your request might not get met. I think that wording comes across in that way. And so, to me, it just feels off kilter. Nobody's trying to like go control somebody else. But here's the thing: if I want to go over my kids and
don't find it at the library. I get on Amazon and I order it with my own personal money. And so there are people who have done that to build their own library because they can't find certain books at our library. And I think that's what I'm bringing attention to is that there are classic books that were written even before 1989 that have literature value to them. And is our library balanced? If there's no accountability and there's no policy on how these things are coming in through our doors, then how are you to even know that there's balance?
Well, there is a policy.
For me, I look at this circulation and it would have been so helpful to know, okay, manga is the most, what is it called? Kept out thing in our, that is circulated. I feel like as the board, we should have that information in front of us of what is checked out each month. It's not that someone's coming in to try to micromanage, but we, our job as the board is to make sure that we are serving our community as a whole. And I will tell you that in the circles that I sit in, people don't feel like the library is serving our community as a whole. You have books being hidden behind shelves. Why do parents feel the need to do that? That's a great question. What is the need that they don't want that in front of their kids' faces?
But if we weren't meeting the community needs as a whole, then wouldn't it be reflected in our circulation statistics? And wouldn't it be reflected in our programming attendance? And the fact that our circulation statistics are have actually continued to go up and that our programming attendance is incredible, even compared to bigger cities like Bismarck or Mandan or Grand Forks. That was why we were awarded $50,000, was because of our summer reading participation. And so I understand that you are part of a community that may feel this way, but I don't know if it necessarily reflects the majority.
I think looking at our agenda too, in our unfinished business, we are looking at the collection development policy. Can we have a discussion around that? And I think as we look at proposed changes for updates after NDLA and have a chance to reflect over the next month on that policy and potentially approve a new policy, I think that's where a lot of this conversation can happen. Not negating the importance of it right now, but we do have a lengthy agenda and I think that will be addressed through that conversation. Any other questions for Ms. Small? Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, so in the unfinished business, we last month decided to go through the trustee manual.